Hi, Korea. What's tea? This is my first time here, and I've really enjoyed it, and it's been really cute. I hope to come here again, hopefully for a bit of a longer bit, or to do some touring or performing. And I'm aware of like K-pop and, you know, the industry here, and I'm a fan of some of the artists and the music, and it's been great to get in the studio with some of them here, and also your food. I do like the food. It's pretty good food. That's an interesting question, you know. Actually, I probably would have gone for Uzo, because Uzo is my real nickname. You know what I mean? Like, and I think like everyone calls me that. That isn't. I don't know. Anyway, I think I probably would have gone for Uzo, but I think MNEK has definitely been out there for a while, so I think I want to stick with this one for a second. And you know what? I feel with all those like ones with the bigger names, it's their songs. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not precious about it. I think it'll be different if I was just a songwriter and primary, like just doing that, and I could hold on to them songs a bit more. But I have the luxury of like making my own records and being precious about those. I love the songs that I'm a part of, but I'm not precious about anything. I'm precious about my stuff. I have to be. No one else is. The BTS collaboration came about. I actually wrote a song called Mouth. Yeah, it was just a song that we wrote. And then I guess the BTS's people loved the melodies, and they wrote a new song over the melodies, and it became this. And they like did all the harmonies, and they sounded amazing. Like, they really did a great job on it. And their fans have been so great and so supportive and nice, and it's been really great to be introduced to that fan base and to be within that world, because a lot of people know who they are and they seem like good guys. Of course there is, but you know. But yeah, I mean, all the things will happen when it happens. And I'm always interested to work with the next new artist or to break an artist, you know what I mean? I feel like that will be the most rewarding thing when I'm able to re-break. I've been able to like work on an artist's like first single, or to, you know, do all that. There's many instances of that over my career, but I've never broken an artist like with a career just like going off doing their thing, you know. And so I think that would be the next step as far as like my writing and production and breaking myself. Jesus, let's do that. I called the album Language because. I guess it was a title that I had for a long time. I just kind of kept it. I had it initially because I had a song called Language that ended up being an interlude on the album. And then I guess the title just stuck because it meant so much, so many different things as I was creating the album. And it made sense because, you know, so much of this album for me has been me longing to be understood and me understanding what it is to be an artist and understanding things about myself, my sexuality, my taste in music, what I wanted to say in my album. And it's just been a fun experience. I'm enjoying the language of being an artist, and there's some things I'm definitely not as fluent in, but I know that it's a learning curve. And this is my first steps into learning this. And so I'm excited to learn more. I'm excited to make more records and to have more things to say. But this is the first step. And I guess I'm excited for people who have heard it. I'm excited for people to hear it. And yeah, the people who bring color to my life is my friends. I'm so thankful to have them in my life because they are a constant. Like, boyfriends and all that stuff are gonna come and go, but then it's like your closest friends are always gonna be there for you. And yeah, I'm always excited to see them. They literally, I care about them so much, and they care about me, my family. And music. Music brings color to my life. So I'd say those three things. Oh no, you gotta listen to the whole thing.
Absolutely.
Start to finish. Period. No questions about it. That's the way it's been designed. But no, you know what? Like, all jokes aside, I have designed it to be listened to from start to finish, just as like a, because that's the way I've just made it. I wanted it to, each song to, I do feel like every song is there for a reason. And so I've, as a result, I've glued everything in that way. And I've sequence the album in that way. Of course, I have my personal favorites, and like I have my songs that I love the most, and I love Honeymoon Phase. That's one song that I love because it's one of the more R&B songs, and it's, you know, it's a long song, and I get to just wail a bit at the end. And I love Girlfriend just because of the message that it has, and that it's like really tongue-in-cheek, and it's been a lot of fans' favorites as well. I also love Correct, because Correct was like a learning experience for me, because Correct is one song where I'm talking about, I guess, my career up until the point, like, and recognizing that there's nothing wrong with saying those things, because like sometimes I feel like when I'm proclaiming what I've done or what I've achieved, it's like bragging, and sometimes it's not bragging. Sometimes you're just saying what you've done, and there's nothing wrong with that. If you've earned what you've achieved, no one should take that away from you. And I've earned everything that I've achieved. I know I've worked really hard to get where I am today. And so the song is about that, and it's telling other people to own up to when you've achieved something, no one should take that away. Co-directed the Correct video. So, and I want to be co-directing my videos and having more control, just because like I see music videos very similar to the music. It's just they go hand in hand. The editing process, the sequencing, being in control of the energy of the video. Like it matters a lot to me. I watch so many music videos. You know, people watch movies and TV shows. I watch music videos. And so it means a lot when a music video is good to me, and when a music video is like really like dog shit. And so like it matters to me. And so it's great that I'm now at a point where people around me respect me enough to be like, you're allowed to co-direct your videos and you're allowed to have your say in it. I think moving forward, I want to, because this is a whole career for me. It's not just about being a recording artist, because I do all these things. I'm singing, I'm writing, I'm producing. I want to do so much more. I want to do more records. I want to continue to make more records for other people. Now, I guess the next step is to like, because I saw this Quincy documentary and I'm just like, I'm star crazy over that. I just saw that and I was like, right, that is goals. Like to see like a black man be so influential and instrumental in so many people's careers, and everyone just like has so much love for Quincy Jones, and like, and that's because of what he's done, you know? And so I wanna build an enterprise, and I want to, you know, continue making music. And I also wanna help influence other black gay creatives, and you know, I don't wanna be the last doing what I'm doing. I want there to be a plethora of us around. And thank you so much. I've been MNEK, and it's been great to be in Korea, and I hope to come back soon, hopefully to do some performing. And bye. If your girlfriend knew about me and you, about what we do, tell me what would she do? Yeah, if you told the truth and said the word, someone like her just isn't right for you, cause you're go. I wish you would come out.